There are several problems across Bengaluru which have been ignored by the public representatives in the Palike. Even though the citizens have raised their voice against the lackadaisical attitude shown by the BBMP officials, there seem to be no action on the ground. Hence, all white-collar professionals fed up with the governance want to contest in the upcoming election with the banner Bengaluru Navanirmana Party. Take a look.
Civic activists float new party to contest BBMP polls. Campaign seeking transparency in Palike. The Bengaluru Navanirmana Party, an outfit spearheaded by various residents' welfare association in the city, is gearing up for the BBMP polls with an exclusive manifesto for several issues across the city. The party plans to release 20 issue-based manifestos that would deal with various civic issues plaguing the city. Party co-founder Shrikant Narasimhan has said they aim to bring about changes in the society with active citizens.
We've all been active citizens of the city who've been trying to work on various issues, whether it's garbage or the potholes or the stormwater drains, and just generally bringing good governance to the city. What we have realized is the current parties which are there, which are governing the city, and most of the elected representatives don't seem to have the integrity or the competence or the plain intent to get anything done for the city. We all feel frustrated about what's happening with our city or what's not happening with our city. It's that frustration, it's that anger, which has now translated into a lot of us citizens who have come together to float this new party.
The party is also aiming to contest in all the 198 wards in the BBMP polls to take place in April.
Our sincere effort would be to find the good candidates who can contest from all 198 wards. So the idea is to contest across the city. We already have a presence in more than 60 wards.
Party to identify active citizens as candidates. Candidates to be chosen from RWAs. Doddanikundi is known for the dilapidated roads and the garbage menace. Even though the citizens have raised their voice to get the roads fixed, there seems to be no respite for them.
We are actually expecting a minimum roads, which is not available. And there is no skilled persons. If at all, they have to make some kind of manholes, UGD pipes. And again, unskilled person, they have done half a feet above the roads, which is really posing danger to the two-wheelers. Similarly, there is no footpaths. Last year, monsoon season, really many people has flooded into that footpaths also, because there are so many holes. They are really not bothered about the footpaths. And even senior citizens, if you talk about any age group, women or children, they're not safe. There is no safety in the Doddanikundi ward.
HSR layout, which is one of the cleanest wards, is known for the waste segregation, but yet there are problems that are persistent in governance. The residents there feel left out as there seems to be no transparency.
What I felt is, to get the change now, which even I am an act, as my fellow member said, we are actively participating in a lot of social, civic activism, but I think to get the change somewhere, we have to get into the system. I think the time has come. We cannot be like a problem tellers, as a, this is the problem, BBMP is a problem. No, that is not the thing. I think we want to be transparent. If we want to see the change, let's be the change. At least I will give a try. I'll give my 100% to work for people.
Koramangala, on the other hand, is a very busy area and is famous for traffic snarls. The white topping work in the area is the main cause of concern.
There is so much dust. Everybody I know has been visiting a doctor in the last few weeks. Everybody I know, right? It's unlivable almost. It's, you know, we could definitely, I believe, we could definitely run the city better. Bangalore can be managed better. All of us can together do it, and I'm willing to do my bit for this.
Residents joined the movement against bad governance. Citizen activists to support the cause of 198 wards.
We've had enough, I would say. Like, we've been waiting for this from a long time. And I think the time is now. We all need to get together. And it is, you know, our citizens who have to come forward and support causes like these.
We believe that to bring a local change, the BBMP is the most important organization, not the MLAs, not the MPs. Maybe they are also involved, but For us, it is the BBMP which is the most important organization.
Political advocacy that has been started as a citizens' movement certainly needs a blueprint that looks at development control regulations, urban planning, and ensuring density and other primary and secondary infrastructure are dovetailed to ensure that facilities that reach the people have the right kind of investment.
Youth feel demotivated in current governance. While the youth is considered as the future of the country and should be motivated to bring out a difference, they feel suppressed in the city as of now. The youth want to see a change where there would be a platform for them to take part actively in changing the city.
I have seen many youngsters very actively participating in cleanup drives, footpath campaigns, and they're doing fantastic work. Why is the system so difficult for youngsters who are interested to participate and bring change in the society? It's an untapped potential, 65% of us, and I think the government is not looking at this untapped potential at all, and they should. And more young people should come into the space of politics and make the city better for all of us. Yeah.
Some of the party's core team have formerly been members of the Bangalore Apartment Federation, Whitefield Rising and Federation of Villa Communities. Members also include activists from Heritage Beku, Samriddhi Trust for Education, Citizens for Bengaluru, Citizens for Animal Birth Control and Pothole Raja, among others.
Few more months left for the grand BBMP elections, where all of them will be contesting going forward 198 wards which will be going for elections. The main motto being that they want to see a change. They want to see some development across the city as well. And what better way to say that we as residents, we will be standing for elections and we will be bringing those changes which we expected from the representatives for all these years. Well, at the end of the day, at least now, for the next few months, wherein these corporators are there, all we can say is go ahead and say Jagore BBMP. With Kamal Prasad Murthy, this is Suraj for News 9, Bengaluru.